So there's a reason that we left the senator for the end, not only to say the best for last, but because we knew that after hearing from CalPERS and hearing from our city folks, she might be feeling a little dejected and overwhelmed by the task in front of us. But you know, the senator has been such a champion on this issue from the moment that he's gotten from the to the California legislature, even before that. And ACCOC has been so proud to support so many pieces that he's doing on pension reform and pension stability. And so we wanted to give him the opportunity to talk about the work that he's done, what he kind of sees as the path forward, and hopefully leave us all here, maybe not feeling elated, but knowing that there is a common path forward if we all work together. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce Senator John Warnock. Yay!
Thank you, Chelsea. Thank you, Terry. Thank you, Kelly, and all the other 10 names. In the room, my dad's name is Kent, so I feel kind of good. I got a case here today, but I just want to thank you for coming, and I want to thank you for your candidness. This is quite remarkable. If it were appropriate, if I could legally do it, I would give you all a hug. Sorry. So there is CalPERS, which is different than CalSTRS, which is different than the UC system. So it's been real interesting to get acquainted with everything up in Sacramento. I was not supposed to be on the Senate Public Employment and Retirement Committee, but somehow Jean Fuller, when she became chair of the Republican caucus, she tried to get off and told Kevin DeLeon that I was the only one who wanted to be on that committee. And Kevin wasn't really excited about it, but since she kind of forced him, it's been kind of fun. So I'm on that committee now, and I just want to share a little story about Sacramento, because you as city council members, you get your agenda packet a week before the meeting, theoretically. As a board of supervisors, we got it on Wednesday morning, we would vote on Tuesday. In Sacramento, I get my agenda the night before. Literally the night before, except for Monday session, I get it on Friday. I'll get it today sometimes, I'll have the weekend. But I get things just at the last minute, and it's just kind of an interesting environment, a lot different than being at the county level. So let me give you a little state level fun. When I write a bill, we work through Ledge Council, and then it is referred to a committee. These are from the glossary terms on the Senate website. So there is also the term double referred, which means that if they don't like the bill, they're going to make it go through two committees. Sort of. But they do not have a definition for triple referred. They do not have a definition for quadruple referred. The reason I bring this up is I did a bill 2 years ago that got quadruple referred. And you have to go through the consultants of each committee. So with that, we did Senate Bill 1251, the financial transparency bill, where we were saying, hey, in the voter pamphlet, you know, just take a half page, because you get like 192 pages, the last one, right? Just take a half page, and then also on the website, posting, just providing financial data from the state's comprehensive annual financial report, the CAFR, and we thought, let's throw in the deferred maintenance. Fullerton knows its deferred maintenance. Why don't we tell what the state needs to do to repair its roads? And so what I ran into was the kind of the George Carlin effect. I had seven numbers. He had seven words you couldn't say on TV. I mean, we had seven numbers that all of a sudden the Senate did not want the public to know. One, what is the immediate past fiscal year state revenue? Two, what was the state spending? Three, what's the current unfunded state pension? Four, the retiree medical liability? Five, the unfunded transportation infrastructure needs? And then let's also give them the current issue debt for our bonds, and let's give the current net unrestricted assets or unrestricted net deficit, or we call it now the net position, unrestricted net position. Let's just give those seven numbers. So my staff gets a call from the consultant. She is in tears, literally in tears, for the Public Employment Retirement Committee. Why would you want to tell the public what the pension liability is? I mean, this was killing her. And we were just like, this is amazing. So here's the consultant. You got to get to the consultant, because she's going to write the staff report. And then you know, so we could kind of see where this was going to go. So if I had to do it and it would pass committee, because once a committee kills a bill, it's done, gone. So I had to go through Senate Public Employment Retirement, then I'd have to go to Government Mental Organization Committee, and because I'm using the voter pamphlet, excuse me, I'd have to go to Elections and Constitutional Amendments, and because it might cost some money for that page, I've got to go to Appropriations. And then I got to go to the Senate floor, and if I get a task on the Senate floor, then I got to do it all over again on the Assembly side. This is Sacramento. This is just such a fun life. So I took it to Senate Public and Employment, and Senator Bell says, you know this one number on the maintenance, and he's the chair of Transportation. He says, you know, this bill, this number on the maintenance cost, that's an estimate. So I'm voting no. Really? That's it. When you're a Democrat, they'll say, why don't you amend the bill? Why don't you just take out number 7 and we'll just go with 6 numbers? But if you're a Republican, oh, there's one thing wrong, we're voting it down. It's really kind of an interesting paradigm. So that took care of that bill. That's why I sort of mentioned that. So just to tell you what kind of environment I'm in. So I want to talk about pensions just like you. And I just want to announce my staff that are here. So I've got John Seiler is here. Allie Henderson is my scheduler. Deborah's here. Spencer Street is here from Sacramento. I also have Eric Dietz, who's my ledge director in the back. So if you need anything done, let's see, I hope I've gotten her. Deborah, I can introduce Deborah. Scott Carpenter and Charles, my intern, is here. He's also my new bodyguard. Stand up, Charles, where are you? You already leave? Okay, there he is. Okay. So, I got a call from a gal named Judy Lynn from Cal Matters, which is like an online news in Sacramento. It's funded by money out of Silicon Valley. They wanted to have an independent news source, and she calls up and says, I'm doing some research on pensions. It seems like what you've been talking about is really a problem. And it's like when a reporter says that, you kind of, oh. Because I've had so many discussions over the years, like one reporter, one of my favorite lines is, so what does you all mean anyway? It's UAAL, So she says, I'm working with the LA Times and I'm working with the Capital Public Radio and working on a series. And can I record you? So for an hour, I just kind of dumbs. We had a great conversation. But here we go. And we've been talking about SB 400, I mean, how many times today, but you can see when it hit and when the recession hit, you got your numbers, and we're supposed to be up here and we're down here. And the LA Times printed the article, and it's been doing a series. But when you see pension crisis on page one, top of the fold in the LA Times, then there's gotta be a pension crisis, right? I mean, this is